All right. I guess we're gonna jump into this.
Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Cyclo Hunter, and welcome to this video of Beacon Pines. But before that, I want to let you guys know something. My content for YouTube is actually gonna be changing now because, personally, I didn't like what I was doing with my content at the beginning. Mainly because my content was turning into, I need to do this, to where it made it to where I don't want to do it because I needed to do it. I wasn't having fun with it. For a perfect example, Bad Boys Girl and Gacha World, both those were wants at first. But then when they started getting credibility, needs were coming in. But at the same time, the want was still there. With these other games I've been doing, there was wants at first, and then needs came out. And then the wants went away, and then my brain decided to say this. That's what happened with Gotham Knights, that's what happened with Assassin's Creed 3 now, and that is what happened with a lot of other games I have played that I just discontinued, where I just didn't want to work on them because the need was overweighing me wanting to play it or even record it or do anything with it. My content is no longer going to be like that. My content is going to be what I want to post and also what I feel like is fun. Because the whole goal was me playing with my friends for the YouTube channel, but because of Fallouts, that is no longer great. Now it is just me wanting to post fun moments. Because I personally want to have fun making my content. I want y'all guys to have fun watching it. And I just want everyone to have a great time. So, yeah. Take care, guys. Enjoy the video. We're going to be playing some Beacon Pines today. From what I know, this is a mystery indie game that came out. It came out for Game Pass. So, want to check it out. It's been out for, I believe, 2 weeks already. Wanted to check it out a while ago, but I was dealing with stuff. Wanted to take a little bit of a break. And also dealing with Overwatch as well. Talking here and there about it. All that stuff. So, let's go ahead and jump on into Beacon Pines, everybody. Spooky, scary skeletons. See, there you go. I was prepared for Halloween. I told y'all, maybe. Not really. I don't know, but we'll see.
Dear reader, allow me to introduce you to my book. Though it might at first appear like many books you've come across, it is far from ordinary.
How so?
You may, therefore, have some misunderstandings about its nature.
How so?
The story that awaits you has not been fully told.
What do you mean it hasn't been fully told? Tell me now!
In fact, its conclusion is not yet known, even to myself.
Okay, you've piqued my interest.
It is in that way that my book is special.
Sounds pretty special if you think about it.
It is in that way that you are special.
Ed?
Without you, there is no story.
Fucking know it, bitch. Now
Chapter 1. Normal isn't what it used to be. This is a story about change.
I hate it!
No, I'm joking. Nestled in a shallow valley is the town of Beacon Pines.
I have like one ear out because, dude, I can't hear shit. Oh, fuck. Stop hitting shit.
Far from the town square, across the river, past the neglected welcome sign, a young boy walks alone at dawn.
Okay.
His name is Luke Van Horn, and like you, dear reader, he's here for a reason.
To be... No, I'm joking. Be stupid? No, I'm joking. Oh, hey, well... Oh, hey, cool, I get to control him. 360s! That tombstone? Hey, Dad! Oh, how things going? You know? Yeah, how are they going? Today's the first day of summer vacation. Yeah. I start middle school, like, next year, I guess. About, whatever.
Alright.
I was 6 years old when you died.
Great way to explain how long it's been. Not really.
And it's been 6 years now, and from here on out, you'll have been gone longer than you were here. Some fucking bullshit! Wait, what?
Wait. You would have been here longer than you've been... Your dad.
Are we talking about animal years, or are we talking about, like, real life years?
You have been gone longer than you were here. Are you talking about with you?
It feels like that should remain. I mean, that should mean something, you know. I mean, come on, man. Mom always said that his tree was your, or that this tree was your favorite spot in the world. You know, like, yeah, bro.
Yes, I know. My voice acting is top tier.
Me too. I'm crying like a bitch.
Hey, Luca, you son of a bitch. I knew I'd find you here.
Rollo was Luca's closest friend.
Sick.
He possessed many fine qualities, but subtlety was not one of them.
Okay.
Well, after I banged on your door to your grand answer, then I banged your grand-grand. Just saying. And after I checked the pond and climbed up to the tree house, then I knew it find you here.
Rollo finally noticed the tear swelling in his friend's eyes and the flowers on the grave.
What, you a punk-ass bitch? Oh, yeah, right. You and your mom always did this on your dad's birthday.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
I already forgot the voice. I didn't know if you were going to keep doing it now that your mom's gone too. Oh, fucking hell, dude. Don't. God damn it. Oh, God. You don't say that. You're just gonna, like, make things fucking worse for him. I mean, God, he already lost his dad. Now his mom? Come on. He's not young, dead. Can I just talk normally for him? I feel like he's the main character. I'm just going to talk normally for him. She's not gone, okay? She's just...
missing. Bitch. Sorry, I meant to say since she went missing. Furries.
Look, she's going to come back, Rollo. I swear.
Of course she is. Maybe. We'll see.
Okay, Dad. See you next time. Yeah.
Just fuck, say fuck it. Go back to the other voice.
I think I'm ready to get out of here. Yeah.
Sure. Lead the way.
Can I interact? Ooh. Yes. Pop them all. They will all be popped. Okay. Can I fuck with us? Oh, cool. Tickle, tickle. Is it actually a charmed life? Found a charm. Oh, hey, that's pretty cool. Can you... Oh, you can do that?
I had a good feeling about you from the moment you opened my book.
I'll open even more, lady. I'll spread them sheets. Shut the fuck up.
It's a very special thing. Very special indeed.
How so? What can I do?
Keep hold of it for now.
Okay.
Its purpose will reveal itself soon enough.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean, originally I was going to just pop them on to see if it, does he, like, sneeze? He does. Oh, that's pretty sick. You know, because I was going to see if I could interact with other stuff. That's what I'd normally do in these type of games.
Oh, yeah, I almost forgot. The whole reason I was looking for you.
I was wondering if you'd ever get to that.
I found the perfect way to start our summer, motherfucker.
Oh, how's that?
Rollo looked to the side suspiciously.
Not here. That's right, you're gonna get fucked. What? They might be watching. Oh, correction. They might be watching. They?
Who?
Shh! Not so loud! We need to do this in a secure location. Mission control.
Alright, I just had to tell Gran and then we can head out.
What are you gonna tell her?
I don't know. I think it's something.
If it's all the same to you, I'll meet you at the welcome sign. Your grand still kind of wigs me out.
What?
I don't do well with new people. So is she coming to visit, or is she like, is she living like, or is he living with her because since now his mom's missing and everything? She moved in like half a year ago. Okay, never mind. Okay. Okay, so yeah, so he didn't move to her, she moved to him. Okay, that makes sense.
Just me at the sign. Just meet me at the sign when you're done. Yeah, motherfucker. We're gonna be doing some furry shit this summer. We all know what they do. Alright, so I won't be long. God damn it.
I had to ruin myself. Okay, let's just go.
Tell Gran before heading out with Rolo.
Okay. Can I... What the...
Can I interact with other things, actually?
What can I do?
I love how this is what everybody does. They, like, full-on experiment with the entirety of the thing. And then we... Oh, hello. What's this?
I'm just fucking chilling, dude. I don't know what you want from me. Welcome to the game, bitch.
Okay.
Dear reader, forgive me for this interlude.
Sup?
Remember that charm you found in the dandelion patch?
Yeah.
There are more of those special charms to discover throughout Beacon Pines.
Okay.
They've been known to reveal themselves to those who are willing.
Okay.
Some of them can be found in this very house.
Some. So there's multiple. Yeah, I was gonna say. That just makes sense to begin on that one. So we got Ponder, we got Tickle. Interesting. He just slides down. Am I playing? Yeah, he. Okay. Yeah, Nick. So it is a he. Because sometimes there's been times to where the character's a female, but I still say he. So, just want to make... Oh, in this case, with anthropomorphic stuff like that.
Luca had spent countless hours...
Furries.
...anything and everything with it.
Spent countless... Okay.
Not for years, though.
Why'd he stop? Well, it... You know what? I shouldn't have asked that, because obviously if it's... If it's something that is, like, with his dad and stuff, and he was close to his dad, yeah, it can make an impact.
Since Gran had moved in, the house was more peaceful, more orderly... And
that's good.
Covered in flowery fabric.
Fuck yeah! Actually, wait, what the fuck is with that? How come my grandparents always go to, like, flower fabric and shit? I just realized that, because my grandma had it, and I'm pretty sure everybody's other grandma has that type of shit. They always have, like, the flowery fucking furniture and shit, or covers, or whatever. I just realized that. Is that just, like, a thing grandparents do? I'm exploring everything right now, okay? I just want to make sure that there's nothing I'm missing. Because now, they make me want to get all these goddamn chops!
Luca paused at his parents' bedroom door.
Oui.
He just wasn't ready to go in yet.
I was! No, I'm joking. How about going?
Commandeered the upstairs closet when she moved in. Some things need shelter from a young boy's mischief, she said.
Hide. Okay. Well, there you go. That... might be it then, because some usually implies two. Wait, do y'all sleep in the same fucking room?
Gran's bed was undisturbed.
Oh yeah, well okay, well yeah, no, I guess that makes sense.
Luca didn't mind that she had a habit of falling asleep in front of the fireplace. It meant that he could read late into the night.
Yeah, at least he took advantage of it.
What am I doing here? I don't know.
Bed, let me go to bed. Put my shit up.
Wait, could I get on top? Damn it! I was gonna laugh my ass off if I could.
Luca tossed on his favorite old sweater.
Fucking know it.
Even though it was the first day of summer, a chill still hung in the air.
Yeah, chill, motherfucker.
Gran's moving in meant that most of Luca's things had been crammed in the corner. Luca was somewhat annoyed by the situation.
That is actually us, because But in our household, we have three people living in here. But I have a room. My mom has a room. My brother does not, because he doesn't have a lot of items. So he just said he would just pretty much chill in the living room. And all his stuff is crammed in one quarter. And holy crap, dude, my mom gets pissed about it. But I get where he would come from with that. All right, so I guess Gran's in the kitchen. Yo, where the fuck's this grandma at? Bitch, no, I'm joking. Hey, you old bastard, where the fuck are you?
The only piece of furniture Gran had brought when she moved in was an old hutch.
My Thea has one of those. I'll leave you fucking running.
Scissors, a broken can opener, a mostly empty bottle of glue, and some loose string.
Junk!
An array of prepared meals crowded the refrigerator, each labeled with a day of the week.
Just leave everything open. They'll never know. I'm gonna fuck with Gran. Can I fuck with the stove, actually? You know what? Nah, this shit bothers me already. Just turn everything off. Yeah, that shit was bothering me. I can't do that. Oh man, that was bothering me.
My, this is quite exciting.
Why?
I am now certain that you are the one I've been waiting for all these years.
Hey, yo, baby, you know, I've been waiting for you too. I love reading. In this case, we're gonna spread those sheets. Sorry, they get... Nah, fuck you, I'm not saying that.
You recall I was a bit coy regarding the use of charms earlier.
Okay. Yeah, what about them?
Excuse me. I tend to have a flair for the dramatic.
Alright, real quick. We're going to go on a quick pause. Actually, here, let's see what they have to say.
You
what do they do?
To encounter your first turning point.
Okay.
There are certain times in this tale when everything hinges on a single word.
Okay.
Step forth, dear reader.
So, if I find all these, like, charms and stuff, do they give me, like, special options for, like, the story? If so, that's actually pretty cool. Right now, what do I have? I have... Junk, Chill, Hide, Ponder, Tickle. So I guess we'll...
Young Luca would spend hours hiding in the bushes.
You fucking know it!
To jump out and startle his mother.
Well, then you wonder why the fuck she went missing. She go missing, she ran. She was like, fuck this kid. He's hiding in bushes. Trying to terrify me. We'll see if he can find me.
She always enjoyed humoring him by feigning terror.
Uh-huh.
A sturdy old wheelbarrow.
I was nowhere close to that, but okay. I am fucking hungry, so I'm trying to eat while playing at the same time, and it's terrible. Sloppy Joe's, that's another thing that makes it terrible. Can I move with this? Oh, I can. Awesome. That makes things a lot easier. Alright.
A beginner's guide to gardening laid open on the bench.
Also, Gran doesn't know how to do it. Makes sense. Go talk to Gran. Yo, Gran, you stupid bitch. No, I'm joking. Hey, Gran, I'm gonna go hang with Rolo for the day. See ya. Yeah, there you go. Hold up now, you little shit! Where are you and Rolo headed exactly? Yeah, no, that's not a voice right now. Oh, nowhere special. Just, you know, somewhere.
The less Gran knew, the better for everyone involved.
We're just gonna go... Huh? Ponder, hide, chill for the day. Oh, that's cool.
Just gonna go chill for the day. The best lies are built on truth.
You boys are always in a hurry to do nothing. Hey, look, we stick to what we're good at, you know?
I'll make sure you're done chilling in time for Shepherd.
Easy.
Well, you fuck yeah, it was easy.
Impressive. You've managed to navigate your first turning point without too much of a mess.
It was easy, what the fuck?
That is the power of charms.
Bigger question, hold on. Is it gone? No. Okay, cool.
A single word can change everything. I think it's time to introduce you to the Chronicle.
The what? What the fuck is this? The fuck was the music?
The Chronicle is a record of the decisions you've made.
Oh, okay.
You can see the turning point, which has been revealed. At any time, you can use the Chronicle to go back and invoke different charms, creating new branches.
Really?
Luckily for us, this is the one and only turning point where the charms won't dramatically alter fate. It's the perfect opportunity to experiment with rewriting things.
Fuck it. Why not?
We're just gonna go hide for the day.
Hide.
Traditionally, when one is trying to hide something, they avoid literally using the word hide.
Hey, look, I'm stupid. Yeah, I guess we'll bet some other kids that we could beat them at hide and seek. Are you a little old for that? Okay, look, it's not like there's much else to do around here. Come on.
Oh, actually, you boys are not playing a little game and time for Shepherd.
All's well that ends well.
Now we're going back. We're going back. Hold on. But now it's a little hard because I'm only using one hand while eating.
Oh, Luca!
Oh, shit, what?
You and Rollo stay out of trouble.
Fuck that. I'm gonna get in all the trouble, bitch. It's called Beacon Pines. You know what that means? Fixing to kill a bitch. No, I'm just... I know. Can someone die? Can someone actually... If that is a fucking thing. That is a... And this is gonna be a good game. Alright. Get in trouble with Rollo. Rollo. Get in trouble, Rollo? Gotcha. Suck it, Grink! Come on! Come on! Woo! Dang it, Rollo! Son of a bitch. Welcome to Beacon Pines, bitch! You know the drill. Don't let anyone discover our secret path.
Chapter 2.
Ready? What the fuck?
Welcome to Beacon Pines. For many years, this valley had been a small mining outpost.
Okay.
It wasn't until Sharper Valentine built his fertilizer company that Beacon Pines was established. Over the next 30 years, the town had grown and prospered. Until the foul harvest and his sudden death.
Foul harvest? What the fuck was that?
In the 6 years since, everyone was simply trying to get by.
Gee, that's not good. So then the town is sort of like struggling, is what I'm hearing. Alright, cool. Can I hear what one's saying? Hey, Mr. Kerr. Hey there, pal.
Around town over the past few years.
Okay.
After the failing of Valentine Fertilizer, the town was hungry to welcome a new source of employment.
I mean, yeah, because, I mean, how the hell is the town going to survive without it?
Excited for the big festival!
Oh, sure?
Come on now, when I was your age, there was nothing more exciting than a town festival. The food, the music, the dancing. Come on.
Yeah, sounds pretty alright.
You gosh darn right it is. I'm looking forward to letting off some steam myself. Let me get my drift. What you doing late tonight?
I'm a dude.
And okay. Thank you to invite all your little friends.
Yeah, creepy. I couldn't keep Rolo away if I tried.
Excellent, you'll be my first victim. I mean my nothing. Sorry, Luca, gotta get back to the profitable grindstone.
Grindstone. Excuse me.
Harvest the rates and all that. Hold up! The left side a little out!
Ooh, excuse me. Are you the man?
Oh, young Mr. Van Horn can't talk right now. Very busy with preparation.
Mayor Augustus Valentine was not busy.
Yeah, no, he seems pretty worn the fuck out. Oh. So I guess...
How many times do I... It's Mayor Valen... fuck it.
Flustered, Gus instinctively loosened his tie.
I'm out. Okay, keep up the good work. I must briefly attend to a concerned citizen.
Huh? It's nothing, keep at it!
Alright, what can the mayor of Beacon Pines do for you today?
Oh, just saying hi, I guess.
well, good day to you too, young Van Horn.
My last name is Van Horn? Dude, that's such a badass name. Fuck you, dude! You see this? I have power! Look at that. Can you do 360 spins? It doesn't look like it, but you know what? They count. Fuck you.
See that guy? That used to be me. You all know what I used to do? See that hippo over there? Fucked it. No. Okay.
Hey, Mr. Sinclair.
Mr. Sinclair continued snoring and lifted one eyelid just enough to see who it was. A tactic he often used to avoid undesirable conversation.
Yoo-hoo! Mr. Sinclair!
Don't you see I'm sleeping more?
How's the napping today?
Come as always. You should have a perfectly nice view from here. Till Brunel Harvest put that monstrous of a building in the way.
Why don't you just move your chair a bit?
Why should I be the one that moves?
Sounds like my life.
If there's a show to LA one, it's gotta be the one who blinks.
You just blinked. Alright, who's next? Who to talk to?
Come on, Andy, grab his wallet.
I'm sorry, Iggy, I can't.
Do it or we pawn ya.
Yep. Yeah, but my mom said...
Yeah, but... If I had a nickel for every yeah, but... It'd be the freaking king of nickels, you son of a bitch. Ain't that right, Tish?
Yep.
Are you trying to get this kid to steal his wallet? Are you fucking serious? That's actually pretty sick. Peer pressure, am I right, kids? Alright, what's up, dude?
Oh, Mr. Van Horn, do you have a moment?
Oh, it's just Luca.
Golly, I'm sorry. It's my first week at Brennan Harvest.
He pulled a pen from the pocket of his sweater vest and began to frantically jot something down on the clipboard.
Oh, what the fuck is he writing?
Wonderful. It won't happen again. If we are going to be on a first name basis, then you can call me Pete.
Oh, nice to meet you, Pete. sorry, what are you writing?
Oh, just documenting! Gosh, it's exciting to be part of something so darn special. You know, it's not just about new fountains and phone booths. We're gonna change the world.
You're the bad guy.
And it all starts here at Beacon Pines. Isn't it amazing?
Uh-huh. Anyways, I better get a...
Oh, that reminds me. We'd love to hear your thoughts.
My thoughts?
You betcha! If we're gonna change this town, we need to get every detail right!
That sounds intense.
Ah! Changing the world is intense! So, what you say? Could you answer a few questions?
Well, I guess they're quick.
Wonderful! Open to answering a few quick questions. One down, see, it's not that hard, is it?
Oh, okay, we're going already, awesome.
Question two. What is something you love about the Beacon Pines?
Never really thought about it before.
Perfect!
It's the only place I've lived?
See, that wasn't so painful.
Stopped scribbling and glanced up from the clipboard.
Was it?
Huh? I guess not.
Huzzah! Our first three questions answered in record time.
Are you literally writing down everything?
Thank you so much for your time. I need to process the answers. We can save the rest for your thoughts for later.
Okay.
Our harvest awaits.
Can I go in there? It's a bullshit! Oh, hey, dude. What you up to? Hey, Jetson. Is this the line playing any tune? Wait, is the line playing any tunes today?
No bass this morning, I'm afraid. Come to think of it, can't remember the last time I reeled one in. But it was never about the kitsch. This is where I come to think, really.
Yeah, that's what my dad used to do here.
That reminds me. If you ever want his chair back,
I've taken a stand in recently. Keeps me from falling asleep at the reel. If we don't mind, I think it should stay. If we don't mind, I think it should stay. Not at all. An empty chair makes for a great listener.
You know what? Why not? Yeah.
Whenever Luca saw his dad's chair by the pond, it reminded him of the days they'd pack up a couple of sandwiches and fish until sundown.
Aw. Oh. Go back. Oh, goddamn. So I came actually back out of the flashback. That's it. Can I go in here?
Luca opened the tackle box and picked the perfect bait.
Fucking know it. The perfect bait tickle. What the hell would tickle do in this?
Luca junk? Tied a shoestring to the hook. What fish could resist a nice shoestring?
Give it a good cast, no?
Alright. Woo!
I got a boat, Dad!
What do you think the other one is?
All the same. Sometimes things just drift away.
That's not fair.
Oh, it's not.
Well, whatever it is. I hope that the other boot at least has a sack to keep it company. Or a sock to keep it company. So do I keep going then?
Luca gently baited a feather. Good for skimming the...
Ducky! Well, be switched. It's your old rubber ducky. You're just a little drool bowl of fur when you lost that. Cut for days. I told you to...
So I wondered, so if I come in with more charms, actually I can get more things. Sick. Okay. Fuck is this? Mission control? Authorized personnel only. Are you fucking serious? Literally, you said go to the secret hideout. You fucking put a su- I'm gonna kill you. Rollo, you dumb fuck.
The boys had a good thing going. As long as they kept old Jeff happy. They had an old endless who? Source of precious materials to add to the treehouse.
Who the fuck is old Jeff? I don't know. I gotta get me the fuck out of here. I wanna check shit. Yeah, there's really nothing, okay.
After Luca's father had passed, Rollo became obsessed with them building their own Hank atomic starscraper.
Why?
It was some time before Luca realized it was Rollo's way of keeping him occupied.
I want to take back that why, that rude why, because that's actually, that, okay, yeah. That.
On certain nights, when the clouds were just right, the boys could tune into strange patterns of static.
Really?
Thinks it's aliens. He always thinks it's aliens.
Could be aliens. You never know.
Luca's winter coat decommissioned for the summer. With the cold holding out longer than usual, he reconsidered its usefulness.
Put it on! Fuck. That was right.
Ooh. Luca looked up at the satellite dish. Rollo nearly killed himself putting that up into the tree.
Pull! Oh, nice.
While it didn't turn the radio into an interstellar communicator, as he'd hoped, it did at least boost the signal enough to overhear truckers one town over.
What's that thing up top? Doesn't look like there's anything else. Alright, guess we'll talk. Okay, what's this top secret plan to start our summer?
So you know their abandoned warehouse by my place?
The old Valentine building, yeah.
Yeah, well, it isn't abandoned.
Makes you think that.
Get this. Last night, it was glowing.
Glowing. Are you sure?
Candy.
That place has been empty since...
Since the foul harvest!
Yeah.
Who would even want to poke around that place, man? Come on!
We would, Rollo. We would.
Wait. Okay, look. It's just a busted old warehouse. I mean, I just meant we could do some research at the library. You know, You want to actually go to the warehouse? What do you expect to find?
Answers. My mom's out there somewhere. And it seems like everyone wants to pretend that she's gone for good. You don't have to come, Rodol. You don't want to. Wait, so what? Where the fuck did this get switched? Okay, this feels weird. Because he's the one that brought up the whole warehouse thing. But then now it's like, I want to check it out. Let's go check it out. And then he doesn't want to go check it out. What was the point of telling me then? What?
Luca, remember that time I sort of accidentally burned down the chicken coop? And you jumped in and said it was your fault before my paw throttled me? That is a flame chicken coop sort of deal. I've got your back, motherfucker.
Thanks, Rollo.
Now that I think about it, poking around a decrypt fertilizer warehouse is exactly how I want to spend the first day of summer. Let's go!